Now, the Philippine Health Department welcomes the Internal Revenue Bureau's move to exempt dozens of medicines from value-added tax. Johnson Manabat has more.
The Bureau of Internal Revenue, or BIR, issued Revenue Memorandum Circular No. 17-2024, exempting from value-added tax or VAT 21 medicines for cancer, diabetes, hypertension, kidney disease, mental illness, and tuberculosis. In a statement Wednesday, BIR Commissioner Romeo Lumagi Jr. said the circular was issued in response to a letter from the Food and Drug Administration of the Department of Health that endorsed an update on the list of VAT-exempt products under Republic Act No. 10-963 or the Tax Reform for Acceleration and Inclusion Law and Republic Act No. 11534 or the Corporate Recovery and Tax Incentives for Enterprises Act. According to Lumagi, excellent taxpayer service will be the focus of BIR this 2024. This includes the issuance of circulars that would ease the financial burden of Filipinos that are suffering from the said diseases. In an interview, DOH Secretary Ted Herbosa said he welcomed this development that would benefit those who are really sick. Herbosa agrees that the lack of capability of Filipinos to buy medicines contributes to the fatalities of illnesses. He also shared that the DOH is currently planning programs in PhilHealth to provide free and subsidized medicines for diabetes and hypertension. For Dr. Ronjin Solante, president of the Philippine College of Physicians, this will automatically lead to lower prices of some maintenance medicine, which will be a big help to the elderly and people with comorbidities. According to Solante, this disease are among the top 10 causes of morbidity and mortality in the Philippines. Johnson Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines still a preferred destination for foreign investors, according to the European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines. This despite lagging FDI numbers compared to regional peers, a lower 2023 economic growth number, and the growing rift between the upper and lower houses of Congress over charter change. Lady Vicencio has more.
Investors eyeing to set up shop or expand in the country are looking for economic reforms that will improve ease of doing business, eliminate red tape and corruption, and other trade reforms. Some say it could be done without amending the 1987 Constitution. European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines President Paulo Duarte said companies are looking for reforms that would further attract investments, such as amendments to the Public Service Act, Retail Trade and Liberalization Act, and Foreign Investment Act.
It is then important for us to create a business-enabling environment characterized by streamlined business registration and licensing rules, ease of paying taxes, the enforcement of contracts, among others. This is a prerequisite for building confidence among prospective and existing investors. Nevertheless, the ECCP remains steadfast in its commitment to improving the Philippine global competitiveness and fostering increased foreign direct investments in the country.
It is also the sentiment of the delegation of the European Union to the Philippines, Ambassador Luke Veron. Veron also believes a lot can be done without touching the Constitution amid the division caused by recent charter change efforts.
The Constitution of the Philippines is a matter for the Filipinos. But nevertheless, I don't want to escape your question, because most of the things that we are discussing, including in the ease of doing business and so on, the Constitution has no impact. It's mostly legislation or rules and regulation.
One of the proposed amendment involves easing limitations on foreign ownership of companies. But for corporate and banking lawyer attorney Nilo Divina, there are other ways to reach this goal. Divina also wants the anti-dummy law to be scrapped.
Economic reforms initiatives can be undertaken without having to amend the Constitution. It basically means that foreigners are not allowed to intervene in the management of any corporation engaged in nationalized activity. I find it completely wrong. I was rational for that law. It was probably relevant at that time, but no longer relevant today. We need the expertise of foreigners.
The Embassy of Norway also urged the government to look into policies that will boost trade relations.
our encouragement to the Philippines is to continue to develop good policies and to implement good policies and to avoid bad policies. It's very easy saying it from where I'm standing here, but that's basically the way forward. And we have a very positive outlook. And of course, there are issues that need to be dealt with. That's also very important for the EFTA countries. It's issues like corruption, issues like red tape. All of these issues are very, very important to both increase the trade based on the free trade agreement, but also at the same time, making sure that the Philippines is a country that is investor friendly.
The Philippine economy expanded by 5.6% in 2023, lower than the 7.6% in 2022. But economic managers are optimistic government could hit its target for 2024. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
BMI, a unit of Fitch Solutions, expecting the strong growth momentum to continue in the Philippines. This after GDP rose by 5.6% for the full year of 2023, higher than consensus expectations of 5.2. It notes the latest data reflect the resilience of the Philippine economy, with the uptick in investment as the biggest surprise. Fixed capital investment contribution rose from 1.8 percentage point in third quarter to 2.2 percentage point in the fourth quarter, even as the Banco Central kept domestic financial conditions at their tightest in over a decade. And with the growing possibility of rate cuts in the second half of this year, it's seeing a sustained rebound in investment activity over the coming quarters. Now, looking ahead, BMI expects 2024 to be another strong year, with GDP growth expected to accelerate to 6.2%. This is below government's official target of 6.5% to 7.5% growth this year, as a turnaround in trading activity, it says, is still unlikely. Meanwhile, BMI also standing by its view that the Philippines' tourist arrival levels will fully recover to their pre-pandemic levels this 2024 after recording over 5 million arrivals last year. The forecast for this year, 8.21 million foreign tourists arriving in the country. An economist finds the Philippines' latest GDP data as a pleasant surprise. Manila's National Statistical Agency had reported the country's full-year economic growth for last year came in at 5.6%. Well, that fell below government's target of 6-7 for that year. Alice Takanay of HSBC says Manila's 2023 economic performance is still noteworthy, as the country still emerged as one of the fastest growing in the ASEAN region.
It was indeed a pleasant surprise for us, except for the second quarter of the year. The first, the third, and the fourth quarter were all upside surprises for the Philippine economy, bringing the full year growth to 5.6%, which we thought it would be at around 5.4%. Of course, this is a big pleasant surprise because there are two things that we thought would hinder the Philippine economy. One, it saw the highest inflation rate in ASEAN, and second, it saw the most aggressive tightening cycle across all the central banks in the region, and yet the Philippine economy grew the fastest across ASEAN.
Inflation in the Philippines expected to ease further in January. The Philippine Central Bank projecting the consumer price index in the first month of 2024 to settle within the range of 2.8 to 3.6%. That would be better than December's 3.9%. The BSP cites higher prices of agricultural items like rice, meat, and fruits, along with the increased prices in petroleum products and the depreciation of the peso as providing upside pressure. These will be balanced out by lower prices of vegetables and sugar. The official inflation report will be released next week. That's February 6th. That, plus the latest GDP numbers, are going to be key data to be considered in the BSP's first policy meeting for the year, set for February 15th. Farmers from Western Visayas and Zamboanga Peninsula suffering from over 100 million pesos in losses due to the El Nino phenomenon. The Agriculture Department says the damage from the weather phenomenon spanned 2,177 hectares of rice fields in the two regions. More than 2,600 farmers were also affected, with production loss now pegged at 4,738 metric tons. The DA expects the figures to further go up as data from Luzon and other regions become available. In a previous advisory, State Weather Bureau Pagasa said a strong El Nino will prevail over the country until this month. The latest on Asia's manufacturing PMIs, well, it showed broad improvements for the month of January, with South Korea showing one of the best increases, moving into expansionary territory up to 51.2 from 49.9, suggesting we may be starting to see the bottom in the chip-making industry, also in line with the better chip exporting numbers coming out of the tech powerhouse. Now, only one country, as you can notice, saw a deterioration in the manufacturing sector, and that is the Philippines, coming down to 50.9 from 51.5, although it's still above 50, which is the line that separates expansion from contraction. The growth is slowing. Japan also staying flat, still in contractionary mode at 48. So we've heard of the University of the Philippines offering Taylor Swift classes. Well, here's one for coffee lovers. The De La Salle University Manila's Chemistry Department is now offering an undergraduate elective course that focuses on the beloved beverage. The subject combines the artistry of coffee making with science. It takes place in a laboratory at DLSU that is equipped with electric and manual coffee grinders, weighing scales, and refractometers used to measure the strength of coffee. The subject was launched in collaboration with Coffee Gourmet Farms during the first trimester of 2023. Now, if you're a coffee enthusiast studying in DLSU, you may need to hurry up if you want to enroll, because reports say demand for the course is surging, with online enrollment filling up within 30 minutes.